In this lecture, we are going to talk about how we can give our loops names. Now you may be wondering, why would I want to give my loop a name? And the answer is, if you have nested loops. So if we have something like for I in 1 to 10, and then inside here we have for j in 1 to 10. So let's say if I minus j is 5, then we want to break. And now you may already be wondering, now where does this break take us? Does it take us to the end of this loop or to the end of this loop? Well, let's find out. So we're gonna print out our I and we're also gonna print out our j. And running this gives us this output right here. So the first time that I minus j can be 5 is when I is 6 and j is 1. So let's see what happens there. You can see that actually there's no output at all where I is 6. And that's because right at the start in here, we check if I minus j is 5, which is the case for I equals 6 and j equals 1. So we're gonna break. And now we can see that that's actually gonna take us here. So it's just gonna skip over the inner loop. And similarly, if I is 7, we can see that 7, 1 is printed. So for I equals 7 and j equals 1, this is gonna be 6. So it's still gonna print that. But in the next iteration, when j becomes 2, this is gonna break again and take us right here. So that I will then be set to 8. And there's no other output with I being 7 than just this one. And now you can see why there's also only output for I equals 8 and j equals 1 and 2, but not 3. And so on for I equals 9 and I equals 10. Okay, so now we know that the break only stops our inner loop. So it's gonna take us right here. But what if we actually want to use the break to skip over the outer loop? Well, we can do that by giving our outer loop a name. And the way we can do this is we can give it some arbitrary name and then write an add character. So now the name for this outer loop right here is outer. And if we want our break operator to skip over the outer loop instead of the inner loop, then we can write break at outer. So we have to attach the name of our loop right after the break statement without any spaces or anything. And now we can run this again. And now we can see that once we come into the case where I equals 6 and j equals 1, this is going to be 5, so it's going to go right in here. So it's gonna call break at outer, and that's gonna take us right after this loop, so that there's no output anymore for I equals 6, 7, 8, 9, or 10. So that's how we can give names to our loops. You won't find yourself using this very often, but if you do come into a situation where you want to use something like this, now you know how you can do it. And note that it works just the same way if we were using continue in here. So the labeling of our loops and calling break or continue on a loop of a special name works just the same way. And that's all for this lecture, and I'll see you in the next one. Thanks so much for watching. If you've learned something new in this video, please make sure to give it a like. And also if you're new here, hit the subscribe button and the bell icon to be notified of any new tutorials. If you want to watch more, check over here, and I will see you in the next video.